everybody, and welcome back to the DAOI Talks Expert Series. My guest today is Master Jacky Yao Wu Hu. Master Hu is the founder and chairman of the American Xingyiquan Baguazhang Institute, based in Monterey Park, California. He has over 60 years of experience in the martial arts, specializing in Xingyi, Bagua, and Tai Chi. He is an inner disciple of Liu Jingru, famed Cheng-style Bagua master, as well as Xingyi master Geng Defu. Master Hu, thank you for joining me today. Pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
So I know that you come from a martial arts family. Could you describe how you began your studies in the martial arts as a child?
他说老师来自于练武世家，然后可不可以请老师介绍一下小时候如何练拳的？OK，我们因为小时候是跟着父亲。
Master Hu's family for several generations are martial artists. So Master Hu, since little, he already learned from the martial arts passed from his parent, his father.
Yeah.
Including his grandfather, they all practiced Shaolin Temple style boxing.
然后就把我父亲就把我介绍给他的一个朋友，叫韩德昌。
So his father introduced him to one of his friend, also very famous local martial artist. His name is Master Han Dechang.
Han Dechang is Shaolin Quan.
He is a master of Shaolin Temple boxer.
Yeah, I started to train with him from six to seven.
So since Master Hu was 5 or 6 years old, he learned Shaolin style martial art from Master Han Dechang until he was a teenager.
主要是练，我们练的是少林的，以前是练初级拳，后来就开始一直练到开始散打搏击。
So from the beginning Shaolin Temple until developed to the sparring and like the fighting skills. Yeah.
然后就摔跤。
And the Chinese wrestling too.
等于说我们从小什么都要练习。
So at that time he learned all kind of martial art, Chinese martial art.
那个76年的时候，我就认识了这个两派八卦掌的传人。76年。
So from 1976, Master Hu learned Liang style bagua from Master
Chen Wenqing.
Master Chen Wenqing.
他是跟他练了几年的这个八卦掌。
So learned several years bagua from Liang style bagua from Chen Wenqing, Master Chen Wenqing.
那个79年的时候，在我们我是荆州人，沙市，我是沙市啊，湖北省，沙市人。
媳妇hometown was in 沙市湖北， 荆州。 Yeah.
因为我们那里是武术故乡。
There's a it's a hometown of martial art.
他离少林寺也不远。
That place not too far away from Shaolin Temple.
武当山也是挨着。
It's very close to Wudang Mountain too. Yeah, so the martial art is very popular at his hometown.
所以我们的小孩子都会练拳。
So basically all the kids there learn how to fight. Yeah.
所以说就后来到了79年的时候。
So from 1979,
就是经过一个朋友介绍，我认识刘静茹。Then
from a friend's introduction, then he knew Grandmaster Liu Jingru.
就跟着刘静茹练程派八卦掌。So
he has learned like a Chen style bagua from Liu Jingru since then.
然后就练形意拳。And
also learn Xingyi from Liu Jingru, right? Yeah. From Grandmaster Liu Jingru too. Yeah.
后来我就83年。
And in 1983.
我就去了北京。He
went to Beijing.
去北京就去找刘静茹。To
visit Grandmaster 刘静茹。后来刘静茹因为他在一个学校做老师。一个刘静茹，Master刘静茹 was a school teacher.
他就没有时间。So
he has to teach every day in the school, so no time to teach Master Hu.
就把我介绍给他的师哥。So
Master 刘静茹 then introduced his Kung Fu elder brother.
傅奇富，
Grandmaster Hu Qifu to Master Hu.
就系统的练习。
So Master Hu also learn from Grandmaster Fu,
Fu Qifu,
to learn the complete system of Chen Bagua. Yeah.
就差不多就每一年刘静茹都要去我们湖北。
So every year, Master Hu invites Master Liu Jinru to Hubei, his hometown.
Yeah. 我差不多每一年也要去北京。
And also every year, he tried to find a time to visit Beijing too, from his hometown to see Liu Jinru. Yeah.
就一路很多年。
So it has been like a traveling like every year to learn and like so many years. Yeah.
然后就到了九零年的时候。
Until 1990,
around 1989, 1990.
Then Mr. Hu knew the grandson of Geng Jishang.
His
grandson of Geng Jishang, yeah.
Geng Defu.
Mr. Geng Defu.
He is mainly our Geng Jishang, who is from the Liu Qilan. 刘启南的高徒.
Geng Jishang was the disciple of Grand Grandmaster Liu Qilan. So then Geng Defu is the grandson of Geng Jishang.
Yeah. Geng Defu是跟着耿霞光学的.
Yeah, so Geng Defu's father is Geng Xiaguang. Then Geng Xiaguang learned from his father.
Geng Jishang.
Yeah, so it's a straight lineage down. Yeah.
So I have systematically practice.
So Shifu, Master Hu spent a lot of time with Geng Defu to learn the complete system of Geng style, Xingyi. Yeah.
就那个时候，我们是把老师都是请到家里来教的。
And at that time, Master always invite Geng Defu to live with him, so he can learn more privately with Master Geng Defu. Yeah.
不光是耿德福，所有的我们喜欢的老师。 都是请到我家里来教的。
The way Master Hu learned martial art before is once he knew this teacher was so great, and then he invited that teacher and live with him.
吃住,
and then live with him, eat with him, sleep with him, and then try to learn as much as from that teacher. Yeah.
不是一天的，是几十年的意思。
Not like one day or two days, but years. Yeah.
Yeah. 一直到我们，比如说耿老师他去世了，我们一直要跟他送终。
So even like a Master Geng Defu
生病了，我们要看着。
Got sick, and then Master Hu has to take care of him. And when he dies, Master Hu has to, you know, serve his funeral, arrange everything. Yeah.
所以说，这是中国的传统武术。
That's the tradition of Chinese martial art. Yeah.
它就是一代一代是这样传承。
That's how they pass the art to next generation. Yeah.
Right. 现在就是讲现代的武术。
The modern martial art.
和现在的学生和我们过去的学生是不一样的。
So the right now the student right now is different from before. Yeah,
yeah.
因为现在我们那个时候没有这个 video, 没有这个录像带，什么都没有，就一个电话都很困难。
Yeah, in the old day, it's very difficult to communicate. Not even there's even no phone at that time.
我们都是。 经过写信,
so the way they communicate, because a lot of teachers live very far away, so they have to write letters and then just by mail. Yeah. So every letter is very important to Master Hu and his teacher. Yeah.
我跟刘静茹, 傅奇户, 我们的书信都有几个口袋装的。
Yeah, so the letters Master Hu wrote to his teachers and then the letter they sent.
我现在还留着。
It's like a several, you can put in several big bags and then she, Master Hu still keep those letters. Yeah.
现在有这些东西，有视频呢，有什么东西？
Right now the technology is too convenient, so yeah, sometimes not the you don't cherish those like old day, yeah.
That's true.
因为我们中国的传统武术呢，它主要是说，一直发展到现在呢，因为现在的孩子们和现在这些年轻的人学习这个东西呢，他很多东西呢都不是按照我们过去的传统在学习了。
Right now for the right now for the newer generation, the current kids, it's very difficult to learn the way Master Hu learned before. Yeah.
他就得不到很多老师的真传.
Therefore, it's very difficult to learn the real real martial art from like the way Master Hu learned before. Yeah.
你看，包括不管是只要是传统武术吧，嗯嗯， 为什么现在很多传统武术，它不能够和人家去面对面的去进攻呢？ 它不像拳击呢？它和不像很多西方的一些拳术呢？它主要的问题是在哪里呢？它就是学了一个套路而已。
She would say a lot of problem, like a traditional martial art, a lot of people are criticizing that they cannot apply like efficient, like a boxing or, you know, MMA, you know, it's because right now a lot of people just try to learn the forms. There are so many forms of traditional martial art to learn. A lot of people just want to learn the form. Yeah.
他根本不知道我们过去是怎么学的。
The people don't know in the old day how those older generation, how they learn or practice in the old day. Yeah.
我们过去的一年的工资，才几百个，才最多我们最早的工资是在 Chinese 人民币18块钱。
She would say when he was young in China, it's poor at that time. So there,
一个月,
his monthly salary was only $18 renminbi. Very little, I think. Yeah.
对，那我们还要去请老师来家里。
So not only the daily expense, he still had to save the money to invite Shifu to live with him, other teacher to live with him. Yeah.
我们把一年的工资攒下来。
So he saved all the money he had for like every year.
坐火车去北京去学拳。
Took train to Beijing to learn from his teacher, and then.
对，我们就是跟打拳在打工。
Contribute all the money to his teacher in order to learn something. Very cherished, yeah.
Right.
Cherished, yeah. So he's working hard because all the money is to give his teacher to learn something. Yeah.
所以说我们那个时候对这个拳术就很珍贵。
So it's very valuable, like he cherished the art a lot because it really doesn't get that easy just by transportation or by the money that he has to save in order to learn, and so it's very cherished for him. Yeah. So at that time, all the students respect teacher a lot. It's like a father, like a lot of respect.
Yeah.
Okay, also like even like Chinese martial art, at a lot of countries, the students don't really understand Chinese culture. At that time, students to respect the teacher, respect the follow the discipline. Yeah, very strictly. Yeah.
我们美国也教了很多学生，差不多有20多年。
In the United States, he has been teaching for like over 20 years.
从我这里来了，走了起码有几千个人了吧。
Yeah, probably thousands of students come and left, came and left, yeah.
所以说有几个人能够学好的呢，很少。
So very few students really stay long to learn complete system from him, yeah.
他为什么呢？
Why is that?
他主要是第一个，他不懂得中国文化，他不珍惜。 这个中国的这些武术的东西精华在哪里？
Because a lot of students don't really understand Chinese culture, and then they don't cherish what they have learned.
你比如说八卦掌，
for example, 八卦，
他画几个动作，打几个形意拳，打几个崩拳，皮崩撞爆痕，他就以为他会了。
So a lot of students learn, like for example, 形意 the five elements. After they punch it, then they saw they already learn 形意。 And the 八卦, they know some form, they already know 八卦. Yeah.
这个没有很多年，没有老师亲自传授，因为我们这个八卦掌、太极拳、形意拳都属于内家拳。
Because 形意拳, 八卦掌, and 太极拳, they are all belong to internal martial arts.
那么内家拳，你是指的是由内而外打拳。
So internal martial art means you have to generate strength from inner to outside. To physical, yeah.
现在很多人他不是，他只是动态用手去打拳。
A lot of participants right now basically just use the body to do it, use the physical to do it, doesn't understand the inside, yeah.
那么练内要很长的时间。
It takes a long time for us to understand the inner power, yeah.
学一个套路，只要聪明，可能就是半天可以学很多套路。
If you want to learn the form, if you have a good memory, you can learn it very fast. Maybe, you know, one day you can learn several forms already. Yeah.
所以说是个很不容易的事情。
So it's not easy. Yeah.
那么就是说, 希望将来我们能够传授中国武术, 传授中国文化, 第一个, 所有老师是在国外的, 一定要跟他们告诉他们, 我们一定要按照中国的传统的方式去教他们, 先第一个要尊师重道。
So for those teachers, not in China, but teaching outside China, other countries, Master Hu think that those teachers has to teach based on the tradition of Chinese culture and the tradition of the way how they learn the art.
而且要多给时间师傅。
Just a second.
Sure. 阿阳，我现在有事情，我没办法跟你讲话。好的。
而且要
Sorry. Yeah.
而且要多给时间师傅。
Student need to spend more time with 师傅, with teachers.
对，现在就是每一个人都比较忙，在忙这个忙那个。
Right now, most likely it's like a class. You go there, and after class you leave. You know, and then you go to class, you leave like that. It's not like all day that the relationship between teacher and student are so close, like a family. Yeah.
Yeah, 关键是要坚持。
And the most important is the persistence. The student need to have patience and then follow the principle and then practice daily. Yeah.
就是说中国的传统功夫呢, 它不是说, 它因为我们, 你比如说像形意拳, 是几百年传授下来的。
Like a lot of Chinese martial art, those arts has been passing over from 100 years.
Yeah. 那么就是说他如果不行的话, 不好的话, 早就已经没有了。
If those arts are not good, it's already gone. It shouldn't be passing till nowadays. Yeah.
八卦掌才传到我们民间才100多年。
Like a Baguazhang, since Donghaichuan to right now, maybe only like a little over 100 years.
到我们这个地方, 到我们这里才是, 就是5-6代了。
And it's about 5-6 generation to Mr. Hu's, yeah.
所以说, 这些东西都是很好的东西。
So they are very good arts. 形意 and 八卦 are very good arts.
Yeah, 你关键就是说, 我自己认为, 如果你想打好太极拳,
Mr. Hu believe if you want to be good at the Tai Chi Chuan,
你必须要先从形意着手。
You must start from 形意 Chuan.
然后再走八卦,
and then next one is learn 八卦掌,
再去打太极,
and then progress to 太极拳.
所以说你这样打下去的拳, 你出来的东西就和一般的现在, 你看打太极拳, 现在差不多有, 不管哪个公园, 在哪里, 都有很多人在打太极拳.
So 太极拳 is so popular right now, but if you go see most of the people who do 太极,
要有多少人知道太极拳到底是什么东西。
A lot of people really don't know what they are doing when they do Tai Chi. So Master Hu believe, because Tai Chi is like a very ultimate art, you need to have a start from Xingyi, and then progress to Bagua, Zhang, and then move to Tai Chi. Yeah. Then when you do Tai Chi, inside already have so many very solid art there. Yeah.
Right.
Because
Xingyi
Quan's explosive strength, very powerful.
Yeah. 它比较直,
and the power is more lineage, like straight. Yeah.
八卦掌, 灵果专方比较多,
and 八卦 a lot of coiling.
你再去,
yeah.
把它打成一个太极, 打成圆的,
and then you progress, have those basic like a strength and then coiling, and then you progress to ball, like a circle. Yeah.
你把这些东西融合在一起,
then you mix them.
所以说就是比较高级,
the label become very advanced. Yeah.
所以说现在的练习很多人就是不明白去了以后就跟着打太极,
most of Tai Chi, when they learn, they just teach the form like 24, 60, you know, like 108. And then doesn't really understand what's the
捧力吉安才略走靠。你个形意拳三体是一上好，形意拳一上，它起码你这个手上的捧劲，你所有的兴奋你就要出来。
So when Xingyi, when you do Santi, you already have a peng strength, you already have all different kind of strengths in the pose standing.
你的脚一动一吹, 你的整体劲就要出来。
Once your foot is your back, your foot is pushing, and all the power is already generated.
你八卦掌, 你在走转, 滚骨, 临翻, 你在做这些动作的时候, 你把直劲再加上你的这些圆,
Once you have a very like a structure, like a powerful Xingyi, and then
直立横立,
you have a straight power, and then the cross power, and then Bagua help you do the coiling, a lot of spinning, and then you act these two together, and you become very powerful. Yeah. And most of people use a lot of upper body, a lot of arms. And difficult to experience, very difficult to experience to use the Dantian to
quad
to and the hip to use the power from Dantian hip. Yeah.
So you may have Dantian quad is just a media.
So if you don't have the strength from Dantian and the hips, the power is not going to be unified. Yeah. So he suggests all the in the martial art participant to use the hip and then and the Dantian. And the best part of the arts, normally the looks like a simplest, the beginning. Whatever you learn at the beginning, that's the most important. Yeah. So Xingyi Quan, in other words, Xingyi Quan is the five elements, Pi Peng Zhuan Pao.
The Baguazhang is the Bagua Dinshi.
And the Baguazhang is the eight basic palm. They are the most important part.
Yeah. 然后就是直堂步,
and the straight walking.
然后再达到你再去慢慢去演练的套路,
and then gradually develop to those forms. Yeah.
你不管打多少拳, 你撞回来, 还是要练,
so doesn't matter how many forms you have learned, you still have to go back to those basic. Yeah. Eventually, if you miss the basic, eventually you have to go back to the basic to make it up. Yeah.
所以说基础的东西是最主要的。
So the basic, Mr. Wu, the basic Kung Fu is the most important for participants to practice.
Yeah.
So.
So when you, going back to, if I may, just to, you know, you obviously started very young, and by the time you started studying Liang style Bagua, did you already have a pretty decent understanding of this use of the Dantian and the Kwa for power generation? Was it something that you'd already figured out from your external martial art practice?
Okay, 他说老师在练一开始从梁氏八卦练的时候，老师那时候就了解，就感觉到老师刚刚讲的丹田啊那些东西嘛。 Yeah.
刚开始练的时候是不知道的。
No, it's hard to understand at that time. Yeah.
我们以前是练少林拳。
You can hit this Shaolin. Yeah.
就是外形的东西比较多,
a lot of strength, very strong, a lot of physical strength. Yeah.
你比方说我像我们每天去这个拳, 我们去要打硬的东西, 包括沙袋啊, 包括树啊, 包括我们的肩靠啊, 我们是要拼命的去打的。
So when he learned Shaolin style, he has a lot of
包括我们的脚踢啊,
striking the tree, striking the, you know, yeah. Bags. Yeah, yeah.
当我们练八卦掌, 练到一定的时候, 也起码就是几年以后吧，才开始有点改变，就是慢慢的开始有点改变，有点感觉。So
yeah, he said it takes several years for him to start to gradually understand a little bit, like a inner thing. Yeah.
我每天早上是3点钟起床。And
every day he wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning.
练到7点。And
practice until 7 a.m.
我从开始练八卦掌形意拳到现在，每天是5点。
And until right now, Mr. Hu still practice at 5 a.m. Yeah.
几十年风雨无阻,
it's like a decade, like every day. Yeah.
从来没有停过,
never stop any day. Yeah.
师父领进门, 教我们, 完全靠自己修行,
yeah. His teachers taught him some art, and then whether his achievements based on his practice, his hard practice. Yeah.
我们把这个练拳, 就是练我们这个东西, 当吃饭一样, 每天都要做一次。
So practice martial art is so important to Master Hu. It's like every day you have to eat. And to him, practice is he's eating, like he has to do it every day. Yeah.
所以说我们一路走到今天, 反正, 还可以吧, 就是。
Yeah. That's until right now. Yeah. Yeah.
So can you describe what your daily practice is like when you wake up in the morning? What is the first thing that you do with your martial arts practice?
他说老师5点钟起来每天练习的这个流程是怎么样的？早晨起来以后，我们第一个就是先活动每个关节。 Of course, the warm-up import very important. Yeah.
一般的就是说我们现在站桩是10分钟。
And then he spent like a 10 time doing that 10 minutes doing the pole standing.
就是定步站桩,
static pole standing.
然后我们就开始走单行步双行步。
And then we start to train the Xingyi, Daixingbu and the Songxingbu means the straight like one leg walking and then two leg walking. Yeah.
然后我们就开始走八卦掌的定步。
And then we start to do Bagua's static walking.
大概这个整个流程下来半个小时。
It's about 30 minutes. Yeah.
就是我们要走这些东西, 然后再开始练练套路。
And then gradually, then after that, we do the form.
下午我们有空的时候,
and in the afternoon, if we have time,
就要开始练气功,
then we practice 气功. Yeah.
就是调节气息, 就是说吸气吐气就要做这些东西。
To do the breath exercise. Yeah.
基本上一天有两次吧。
Basically, it's twice a day. Yeah.
So, you know, you mentioned that you felt like the best progression for a beginning student was to learn Xingyi, then Bagua, then Tai Chi, which I've heard other traditional teachers say that also.
Yes.
When did your Xingyi practice start? Do you do Xingyi before or after you did Bagua, before you started Baguazhang?
You mean the daily practice or
no, like in his life, like in his early practice, when did he begin practicing Xingyi? Like
他说老师在练拳的时候什么时候，他是说先学习八卦太极，那他老师以前在练拳的时候是什么时候开始学习形意拳，是不是他是 is that the question?
就差不多我们七九年就开始学形意拳嘛。 在学八卦掌的同时就开始练形意拳，那么就是我的重心刚开始的时候八卦掌比较多一点，后来慢慢的听我的那个傅琦护老师讲，你要把重心放在形意拳上多一点。
I see. Okay. So at that time, actually, he learned Bagua and also Xingyi at the same time. But his teacher suggests him that he should switch his focus to Xingyi first. Yeah, that's how he had this idea. And then he really experienced that. Have to start from Xingyi. Yeah.
And
so, 所以说我这么多年教学生也是从形意拳第一步形意拳最基础的，然后就是八卦掌是掺合着两边练习。
Yeah. So, so when he teach, he also, the beginner also start from Xingyi, and then gradually mix with Bagua. That's how he teach. Yeah.
达到一定的程度了，就到了一定的高度，就比如说我们形意拳12型全部练完了，然后我们就开始练器械，器械练完了以后，八卦掌我们八卦掌定步、活步、八大掌、游伸掌，然后我们的器械练完了以后，我们就开始练气，练太极拳。 讲太极和形意八卦，我们这个太极拳是综合太极，是形意八卦加上太极拳在里面的。So
she would Master Hu teach 形意 right, and then 八卦, and then after the form, then Master Hu has a system of 太极, but the 太极 is different from the Yan or Qian 太极. It's a combination of 形意 and the 形意拳八卦掌. Combination, Tai Chi, yeah.
就是我们的太极拳里面很多动作与形意拳与八卦掌有关系。So
the Tai Chi Quan Master Hu learned has a lot of relationship to 形意 and 八卦形意拳八卦掌. Yeah.
我们的名字就叫综合太极。And
the name is called 综合太极 means combination 太极. Yeah.
但是我们那个练的比较少。
But Master Hu still spend most of time. Doing 太极 and 形意 and 八卦掌. Yeah.
因为我们的重心是在于形意拳和八卦掌上。
She was still focused on 形意拳的八卦掌. Yeah.
因为练太极拳，你达不到这个境界，达不到这个高度，你教他等于说是骗人家的，没有用的。So
Beijing XIngWu believed that the 太极拳 is the ultimate art. So if student did not have that level yet, it's no use to teach them the 太极. So he still focused on teaching students Xingyi Quan and Baguazhang.
Yeah.
就是说形意也很好,八卦掌也很好,太极拳也很好,不是哪一个,所有的只要是武术,都是很好的,不管是哪一个门派,没有分门派的。只不是说你现在你说说,你比如说八极拳,你八极拳是非常棒的在我们中国,是吧,通臂,螳螂,等等等等等等,这些拳都是很好的。
She would say actually all the martial art, Chinese martial art, very great. Not only Xingyi Quan, Baguazhang or Tai Chi, they are no like you are better, which one is better. He said even including like a Baji Quan, Premantis, Tongbi Quan, Tanglang Premantis, yeah, they are all very good arts.
Yeah. Yeah.
They are all very excellent arts. Yeah.
那么就是说,我们不能够去分 按门派去说，哎，你这个拳好，我这个拳不好，其实都是胡说八道的。中国的传统武术都是很好的。
Yeah, so she would basically doesn't believe okay, people say oh this style is good, that style is good, is no good. He said every style is good, and all the Chinese traditional arts are very good. Yeah.
你包括太极拳
include Taijiquan for example.
杨氏也好，吴氏也好，陈氏也好，什么什么太极拳。
So, Tai Chi Quan, like Quan style, Wu style, Yang style, Wu style, they are all very excellent arts. Yeah.
So,
it's all about the participants, whether the person who practice are doing good or bad. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So, when you have a student who says, like, maybe you have a student that comes to you from a martial art like Shaolin. Who has problem transitioning from use of muscles and external force to using the dantian and the kua? What is something that you do to try to teach that student how to use his body in a more internal manner, I guess, for lack of a better term?
Okay. 他说如果有学生过来之前是练少林拳的,都是全身都是用力量的,然后老师会怎么样去让他把他慢慢
教导这个学生，让他能够开始了解用丹田跟胯啦这些内在的力量这样子。是这样的，就是说，你关键是有一个转换的过程。There
is a time of a transition.
而且你这个学生，你我们就是一条，你相信形意拳，你可以不相信我这个人，你一定要相信这个拳，所以你才要练好这个拳。
对，他意思是说，我知道你转换也是一样的，因为你少林拳，他也练气的，他不是少林拳不练气的。Mr. Wu saying like Shaolin doesn't practice qi at all. Shaolin also have qi gong. Yeah.
所以说，你只是有一个转换一个跑道而已。So
there's a transition to change.
然后你在练习的过程之中，去慢慢的去感受从松柔而发力。
And then from the practice, gradually to experience from relax to generating the strength. Yeah.
你练好了少林拳的人，你再来去转化于练形意、练八卦、练太极，是非常快的。
He said like if you have the foundation of a Shaolin style, it should be very fast to transfer to internal martial art. Yeah.
因为它的基础功夫已经很好了。
Shaolin's fundamental kung fu is very solid. Yeah.
Yeah.
少林功夫在我们中国也算是很好的，很高级的。少林
martial arts very good art too. Yeah.
I know that Master Hu has a Sanda background, teaching and practicing Sanda. Does he find in the United States that sometimes students seek him out because they're looking for more practical applications or practical uses, for lack of a better term, for Xingyi and Bagua? Does that make sense?
他问你，因为有没有人去找你？因为就是心意比较实用一点，或是因为你前面有三达这个经验，很多来找我的很多，在一起交流的也很多。
So he's thinking about like is anyone want to try with him or something?
No. I mean like his other students like 有人去找你，因为他们。
你要学打是不是？学那个散打，因为那个新也是比较有点实用一点，有的不没有那么实用。是这样的，你这个话应该是这样说：形意拳也好，八卦掌也好，少林拳也好，都是有很多是实用的，没有哪一个不是实用的，就只是看你会不会用，你能不能用。
She says, Xingyi Quan Baguazhang and Tai Chi Quan are all very good fighting. Just depends on the student know how to use it or not. Yeah, the participant know how to use those arts. Yeah.
So, when you first came here in 1999, is that correct?
老师1999年来吗？
啊，对对对。
Yes.
And what did you think of the martial arts community? In the United States when you came here? What was your opinion of it at the time that you came here?
老师来的时候觉得那个时候这边的武术的环境或者是美国这边的武术老师那时候觉得怎么样这个环境美国的环境非常好 He says very good here
但是呢美国的这个练中国的这个传统武术的呢这个我当时来的时候呢也有很多人也大部分都是练太极拳的 就是练我们形意拳的八卦掌的很少，不多，也就是说，包括现在在美国也不多，因为在中国比较多，它也是分位置啦，分区域。你看，在我们中国是北方比较多，就是说在南方就比较少，南方有南方的拳，北方有北方的拳。我到了美国以后呢，因为我们整个这个我们以刚开始练的这个东西，很多人还不知道，他还不认识你这是什么东西。So
basically, when Mr. Hu came here. Even those people who learn martial art mostly Tai Chi Quan, very real people knew Baguazhang or Xingyi Quan.
Right.
Yeah.
现在慢慢的认识人比较多了。
So gradually, there are more and more people doing this art, but still, most of people still only know Tai Chi. Yeah.
Yeah.
Never heard about Xingyi or Bagua. Yeah.
Yeah. So you know, you were talking earlier about how much things have changed as far as the student and teacher relationship. How you know modern life, it's very difficult to have the traditional student teacher relationship. So now we live in a time where the information is much better. Like when I was a teenager, it was almost impossible to find a Xingyi teacher or a Bagua teacher. Now you can find some of those teachers, but it's as far as the our lifestyle is much more difficult because the pace of life is so much faster. Would he like to speak about that? What is his opinion of that situation? We have better information, but in some ways, a more difficult for a traditional teacher-student relationship.
他讲到就是说，像老师刚刚讲的，就是以前在中国就是没有什么电话什么东西，所以大家都很珍惜。那现在，录影那个设备通讯设备太方便了，然后每个人的节奏都很快，然后。
所以说学生也没有办法说像以前这样子去学习这样子哈，那老师有没有什么看法？就是像现在这个社会怎么样去？OK，过去的时候呢，因为我们通讯很差，也没有什么好的这个交流平台，就是只有是跟着老师一步一个脚印的走，老师说一就一，说二就二，根本我都不知道。
She said in China because the transportation was very inconvenient at the time, and then there's no phone at the time, so their way of learning is very limited too because they only follow one teacher and whatever teacher say they learn it. They don't even know there's another teacher,
right?
You know, at other places. Yeah, that's before. Yeah.
所以说，我们那个时候呢就很执着。
So at that time, they are kind of stubborn, just one teacher, and then just everything is this teacher. Yeah.
他又有好处，也有不好处。
It's good and bad. Yeah.
他的好处就是我们一心一意的在练习这么一个动作。
So it's the good is that their heart only toward one thing, so they can focus on one art and then spend a lot of time just doing it. Yeah, that's the good thing. Yeah.
不好的就是不知道外面的世界还有这么精彩。
The bad thing is that he only know that. Much only one thing, and they didn't know there are other places or other arts are very colorful too, yeah. Very beautiful too. Yeah, yeah. There are a lot of good teachers somewhere. Yeah,
yeah.
Like when he was young, he thought he was the best.
Because we 通讯很差.
So at that time, whoever around him, he was the best.
Until
he went to Beijing,
我的师兄弟,
he knew some of his Kung Fu brothers there.
然后接触其他的有一些我们老师的这些师兄弟,
and then from the teacher in Beijing, then gradually know the Kung Fu uncle.
我才发现,
know more people.
我们还远远不行,
then realize, oh, he only know a little bit. There are way more to explore. Yeah.
所以说你就更加要努力.
So that also give him some motivation. He need to practice harder to learn more from those teachers. Yeah.
我今年是马上一翻脸就64岁了。
Mr. Hu is going to be 64 years old.
我还在学习。
He is still learning. Yeah.
我还在回北京去学习。
When he went back to Beijing, back to China.
我师父今年是89了。
Grandmaster Liu Jinru is already 89 years old.
Yeah.
我昨天我还跟他视频。
Yesterday, Mr. Hu still we chat with him.
他说他呀，我还有一套雄型，他的以前的套路，在中国很少的。
Grandmaster Liu Jinru told him he has a bear form. Not many people knew that form.
我这几天在家里搬东西，我整理出来的这个照片，我一看这套拳我没有学过，但是我就跟他两人的视频，他告诉我，他说不是你没有学过，他说我外面我一个都没有教，我的徒弟一个都没有教，你也没有教啊。 他说我是写在书里面的，但是没有教，是不是啊？
So Liu Jinru wrote that bear form in a book, but never taught anyone. Yeah.
所以说再不学，他就这个东西就没有了。
So if you know years after, maybe this thing is gone. So when he Master Hu has a chance to go back to Beijing, he want to learn. 老师想学一下。
对，我要赶，
yeah,
我要回去。我就师傅那里要学习，所以说活到老要学到老。
Yeah, so as long as you are still alive, you want to learn. Yeah, doesn't matter how old you are. Yeah,
yeah. That's one of the best things about these arts is that there is no end. There's always something to learn. Always.
Yeah.
So what do you think is the future of these traditional arts in the West going forward? What do you think that their place is?
他说传统武术在西方世界。未来老师觉得怎么样？展望呢，还是什么？
应该是很好的。
Master Hu believe it's a bright future for traditional art to spread to the U.S. To the Western countries.
我为什么这样讲呢
？Why he say that？
现在中国从改革开放，我们应该是讲从80年代末期90年代开始，中国就有很多优秀的，在国内是比较优秀的、比较好的老师，都已经走向了全世界。
So, she would say since China, around 1990, opened the door to the world. A lot of good teachers at that time, right now already teaching at different countries. Yeah,
因为所以说他们带的东西都是比较好的东西。
Because they were good, and then they went to different countries, and they were kind of passing their arts to the Western countries. Yeah.
所以说，我相信在西方世界以后会比，不见得会比中国差。
So he feel maybe the Western, the participant in the Western country will not be, you know, maybe even better than China in the future. You know.
So would you like to tell people, we're just about out of time, but would you like to tell people before we wrap up where they can find you and a little bit about your school?
老师在结束之前还没有什么话要跟人家说还是？
首先就是谢谢了，反正把我们这个中华武术，向全世界，我们这是，
就感谢他有这个机会，
我们也感谢。
Mr. Hu appreciate the opportunity to have an interview with you.So there's another opportunity to introduce him and introduce Chinese martial arts to other people he doesn't know. Yeah.
Yeah. 也如果是说在我们这个美国洛杉矶或者我们这附近的想学形意八卦掌的来找我。
He say, anyone lives near Los Angeles in California, not too far away from here, is welcome to find him and learn from him.
我们欢迎，热烈欢迎。
Welcome. Yeah.
Yeah, that's fantastic. No, it's been a pleasure talking to you, and I appreciate it. And you know, if ever you want to speak with us again, or if you have something that you'd like to promote, an event you'd like to promote or something like that, please let us know, and we'd love to have you back to talk again sometime.
Sure. Yeah.
而且以后如果有什么要再欢迎再的。OK. 好的。我和那个杨兄杨海，我们关系都是很好的。
Yeah, he is a good friend to Master Yang Hai.
Yeah.
杨海的形意拳 very good, 很好的。
杨海形意拳 you know that. Yeah, 杨海形意拳
Yeah, he says the same thing about your 形意.
Yeah.
We're very happy to have you.
Yeah. 是啊。我们都认识的，都是比较好的。
Do you have a Master Hu's, we have a website, you have the address?
Yeah, we'll provide the links to your website and everything in the description for the video, so we'll have all that listed on there, so. All right.
Okay.
Thank you very much, gentlemen.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Have
thank
a good
you.
Day. Thank you.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.